Hello everyone, and welcome back to Dark Souls. So, right where we last left off, so we're gonna head back up to the church and get started on the gargoyles. So, we are gonna use Solaire for this fight to make things a little bit easier on ourselves and get to Capra quicker. I could go straight to Capra, but I'd like to pick up some souls from the gargoyles and just get the bell out of the way. So I am gonna want to go human, but before I do that, I'm gonna take out this guy. Because that guy be a real pain, even if you're a skilled player and you've been through this game a bunch of times, that guy can mess you up. Starting the fire for some reason. Now this guy, if you hit the wall right here, a lot of the time he will aggro and actually start walking over to you. Yep, there he goes. And yeah, he is powerful, especially with that buff. He is very powerful. So here's where I need to learn how these things work, because does force go through walls, for example? Because nope, doesn't look like it. Looks like this guy actually has too much poise, so I am gonna swap out for the shield. If an enemy simply can't be defeated, or no. I mean, if I simply can't beat someone without a shield, like if force is just not cutting it, then I'll probably switch over the shield just because I don't want to, die over and over. But with him taking it out, and he gave me a super easy time there. These hollows are easy. Without that buff. With the buff, they're actually pretty dangerous. And really, actually, I shouldn't even be fighting these guys. Just because I will want to go human. But you know what? Screw it. Let's try him. Let's try him just by ourselves. With the claymore, it might be possible. So I'll be switching between claymore and two-handed, which I'm not used to doing, so let's see if I can actually pull it off here. Two of those things are not like the others. Oh no. Alright. Two, three, but oh, I didn't think he did, I thought he was higher. So that actually does pretty good damage. Oh. Yeah, seeing he can get you with that pretty easily actually. See, but with a decent shield, blocking him is no problem. Yeah, switching to two-handed does give me more of a delay than I'd like. So what I'm gonna do here is actually switch it out mid-fight for the mace, vocal mace. Yep. That's what I get for getting too greedy with the hits. Never get greedy. If you can only fit one hit in, only try to fit one hit in. So just one. See, but that does pitiful damage. So, I mean, at this point, it's pretty clear, you know, we'd want to upgrade our weapons. So I'm actually going to take this opportunity to see if Force can interrupt these guys at all. Doesn't look like it. Like, this guy I could kill doing it this way, but yeah, there's his friend coming to the fight. Yeah. I mean, it just makes it so much harder when you got two of them. Then the one with the flame. So in the interest of saving time here, we're gonna see if we can actually homeward bone out. So... So, yeah, kind of like I expected, didn't go super well. I'm gonna spend these souls, and we'll use a humanity first. Alright, so we'll level up a bit. So we're gonna want intelligence, so I'll get that up to 12. We'll get one more vitality to kind of even that out, and more endurance, because endurance, no matter what your build, endurance is going to be useful. I like to get it at least up to 20. So we'll get Solaire in on the fight, and he'll basically be able to kill the gargoyles by himself. Wonder if there's a player we could summon. Yeah. You know, let's check out this guy. Okay. They're coming back? No. Let's see if we can get a friend. No. Okay. If they summon in, they summon in. We'll find them later. But for now, let's assume that's not gonna work. Fighting this guy on the stairs is actually pretty annoying, even though you have the advantage of his hits going over your head. Because it's hard to parry on stairs, hard to backstab, especially the parries. Parries don't typically work if the ground is uneven. As he's doing his parry stance, do not hit him with a parryable attack when he's in that stance. I could have done a jump attack there. Jump attacks are not parryable. Whips can't be parried. Oh, okay, so he dropped this, but that's not the sword you want. The sword you want is called the Balder Side Sword. So that's the one you're looking for. I'm gonna switch back real quick to the Claymore. Because you want range with these hollows. Plus, the damage allows for a one-hit kill. Like, look at the range. It really outclasses them. Like, look at that. Makes this way easy. And did we free Lautrec? I don't think we did. So he's in his parry stance, so I'll take advantage of that. See, I hit him with that, he wasn't able to parry me. Nope, okay, so we didn't. So this guy can actually assist you in the fight too. So if you're really struggling with the gargoyles, you can free this guy, go back, talk to him at Firelink Shrine. And then he'll be able to help you as well. And that's just really no challenge. Another thing to grab is there's a humanity in here. And especially early in the game, humanity can be kind of rare just because you might not be too good at the game yet, so you're dying a lot. Maybe you burned some humanity already, and so you're running low. So, it's good to pick up as much of that as you can. Certainly, if you're planning to use a lot of summons. I did pick up a so-called soft humanity. Oh, we got a Darkwraith Invader. So, this guy has the Great Scythe. So, I can tell already this guy's a bit of a twink. He's been to the catacombs. I can hear him casting some kind of buff. He is a barrel. okay. So he doesn't know I'm here, so I'm gonna. Well, I'm sure he can hear me, but let's see if we can actually avoid this guy. Because if we can get to the boss door. I'm stuck on a chair there. So he's gonna try to dead angle me. I'm gonna run over here. If we can get to the boss door and walk through it, then we'll be okay. So he's trying to hit me on the stairs. I knew he would do that. But I had sufficient distance where I was too high for him. So we're just gonna summon Solaire and then walk through the door. Solaire will join us in a second, so I'm just going to block. So there's Solaire to save the day. So, I'm gonna play this real defensively since I have Solaire. Just try to block as much as I can. And I will switch back to the mace. Just because I want to be able to keep that block up. And so, while he's fighting that one, I'm gonna go fight this one. Oh, actually broke his poise there. That's surprising. So as you can see, Solaire's just killed the other one, so... Yeah, real easy. And, you know, that's strange that this one doesn't seem to have as much poise as the other one does. It's possible that destroying their tail actually weakens their poise. So that would be interesting. But yeah, as you can see, Solaire barely hurt there. Usually it'll take a few more hits than that. But barely hurt. Pretty much killed the gargoyles by himself. So, with just him, real easy. See what these say. Praise the sun. Gorgeous view. That's true. So already, without any grinding, without even really upgrading anything, we've rung the first bell. In about, you know, 50 minutes of gameplay. And, I mean, really, you could even do it faster than I've done it. So, down here, we'll find another cool character. Don't hit this guy. The first time through the game, I thought he was an enemy. I almost killed him. I am Oswald. Come with me. Oswald, with the other good gesture. He sells purging stones. Normally, if you're a new player, pick at least one of these up right here with the souls you just got from the gargoyles, because you'll need that later. Yeah. This one, I believe, makes it scale with intelligence instead of faith, which might actually come in handy later. We're probably going to end up with a higher intelligence than than our faith. I'm gonna get 2 homeward bones, but other than that, don't really need much from him. I did it. So I'm still deciding, look at all the hollows, just laying in a pile. That's gross. Gross. I still haven't decided what kind of weapon I want to use. I was thinking of getting just a really upgraded dagger to use for my melee. And I think I still will stick with that plan. And so, with that in mind, I was going to find these guys, but actually, no. So, with that in mind, we're going to head down to the lower Undeadburg to get the bandit's knife. So, let's see. The best way to get there would be to go back across the bridge. That's probably the easiest way from here. So, I will actually fight these guys. Oh, and there's one over there. He'll aggro just by you coming over here. Top off my health, because their hits can get pretty close to killing you. Something to keep in mind, you can't backstab if you have your shield raised. So, if you're ever having trouble getting a backstab and you're not sure why, that's probably the reason you're circling around them with your shield up. See, I saw them do the leap back there, and when they do that, it's usually because they're gonna heal. Wonder if I can equip... No. So I might want to get my dexterity up to 12 next. Which I will do at the next bonfire. Because I'll need... I'm not sure what the requirement is on the bandit's knife, but it's at least 12. So I'll just run past these guys. Get the boar to turn that way. And I should be able to outrun this boar. There we go. Dodge an arrow there. Rest at the fire to get him off me. Dexterity up to 12, and so now we can use some better weapons here. S-Doc is 12. So we'll try this out. So getting the backstab to protect me from that guy who could have easily attacked just then, like that, see? So, well, backstabs are more useful than just for killing people. They can also save you in a group situation. Very useful in group PvP. This guy won't show his back to me, so I'm just going to, what? Oh, okay, that was weird. Does this have... Oh, you know what? The S-Doc does not have a pick animation, it seems. I've never used it before. Okay, that's very interesting. Yeah, so I wasn't actually sure if that would happen. Ooh, let's see. I don't know if this guy will actually kill me, to be honest. Okay, no, well, didn't mean to get hit there, but at least it was a good test. I should be able to run across this just fine. Let's find out. Okay, the flame doesn't actually stretch very far when he's up on his perch. So, good to know. And so here's how you get to the lower undead burg the normal way. That's a tip to get down ladders. I didn't know this for a long time. In fact, until just really this playthrough, which is pretty embarrassing, I guess, but... You can slide down a ladder, and to do it, you have to not be moving. If you're already climbing down the ladder, it won't work. So stop, press B, and you'll slide right down. And I'll open up this shortcut. I don't think those guys will follow me all the way down. Whoa, turning around. So, this weapon is real useful for these dogs. Because you can attack through the shield. And after attacking, they can very easily escape. They can do a dodge and they get invincibility frames just like you do. And so, being able to hit them as they attack is very advantageous because they can't escape like that. So we're just going to try to see if we can pick up the bandit knife. This area might actually be a little tricky without an upgraded weapon, but it should be manageable. And so here we'll rescue Griggs and get our catalyst. It's interesting to note that Griggs might very well be an assassin of Vinheim, because he knows the sorceries that their assassins use, like Hush and the Distraction one. And so it's interesting to think there's a dead mage right next to him. So you gotta wonder if Griggs killed him.
I have my sorcery.
Alright, so he'll be at Firelink, and then we can buy his sorceries. We have plenty of flasks, so I'm gonna top it off. I know a lot of people are more cautious with that, but I'm pretty liberal with my use of the flasks. So I'm gonna switch back to this real quick, because of course we have this ambush behind these three doors. And we can take that right out. Can I hit him again? No, okay, so I kind of blew it on that guy. I meant to do a jumping attack. Oh, that's not enough to kill him either. Well, either way, so now they're weakened, so I can hit him through the shield with the S-Doc and be okay. So once I see those... Yeah, once I hear the doors burst open... Oh, that's hazardous. I didn't actually know those guys had Estus flasks. So that's new. Oh no! Oh man. Jerk. So I went for the backstab, ended up getting backstabbed. No. Ooh, that was him trying to go for a parry. So, these guys can, yeah, like, these guys can actually be pretty dangerous if you play around with them too much. And with these weaker weapons, I'm kind of having to. Okay, so this weapon does still have a leaping strike. That's good. Oh, come on, please. Please? Aw, oh, damn it. Target shield's pretty good, actually, still. And I've never really used it, but it has a large parry frame. The parry frame being the amount of time you can actually parry. Like, if I do this animation, only a small percentage of that animation is actually an effective parry. It's mostly just at the start of it, but not so much at the end. I think if I hit this wall, you can see that's when it's sparking is really when the parry is active. The rest is just recovering from the parry attempt. So, something to keep in mind. So, there's another ambush up here, another chance for the bandit knife. Make sure if you're farming to at least have one humanity. Happiness ahead. having humanity increases your item find. Oh. And that increased item find effect caps at 10 humanity. So I don't want to get the attention of the dog over there. That would make this harder than it needs to be. So as with a normal group situation, I'm gonna try to see if I could get a backstab in here. But again, with these guys, as we saw a minute ago, can actually be pretty dangerous because they can backstab you as well. Going for the attempt, didn't get it. Oh no! Oh, see? That was a mistake. When you see him in that stance, do not attack them. Fortunately, I was too far away for him to actually parry me. Having my guard broken. So I'm really not too well equipped for these guys since I'm just chipping off health. Get some good hits in there. See the chance for the backstab, take it. Get over this guy, come on. Oh, I'm fat rolling. Or, well, mid rolling. Having a mid roll is not good. Yeah, that's a mid-roll. Am I really overweight already? Like, I'd rather be naked than have a mid-roll. When hitting through shields, it's always important to keep in mind, though, that your stamina is coming back very slowly because your shield is up. So it's very useful, but it's also a very quick stamina burn. And so with this new armor, I'll probably be switching over. Slightly better, and it's lighter. These are actually heavier. So these are actually a little worse. They got some higher bleed resistance, but the physical defense is what we mostly want right now. And I can still fast roll. So Capper's in there. We're not gonna fight him because there is an important shortcut to open up first. Now. Let's see if I could actually pull this guy. Do I have any ranged? No, I don't. So, normally I might recommend trying to pull that guy with a ranged weapon, because, this guy's right around the corner here. Yeah, so he's in his parry stance right now. Much easier with two. Three is pretty hazardous. Oh, I got lucky there. He was in his parry, but I was too much off to the side. Good weapon though, get your little pokes in. And so here's this lady who sells tons of useful items. Poison arrows are very handy later in the game in certain areas. Bolts. She sells these resins. Rotten resin isn't super useful. Maybe in PvP, but not really. Charcoal is great. It's like the golden pine, except a fire effect. But back here is the shortcut we want to open up. And I will apologize for kind of the use of a lot of shield in this one. I know I said I'd be moving more off that, and I will. It's just, without an upgraded weapon, it's very hazardous right now. But once I get that bandit knife, things will go a lot smoother. But here we go. We'll test out the force miracle a little bit on these guys. So these guys have basically no poise, so it's very effective on them. Oh, hey. Wow. Ooh. That's nice. So, actually a pretty powerful miracle, as you can see. I might have wanted to use that on the bandits. It might have actually helped quite a bit. But, so I'll use that more next time around here. Okay.
I regret meeting you under such a compromise. At least
so here's Greg Silcellus, the sorceries we're looking for. Well, then. And so, magic weapon is super useful. Not sure if we want to pick it up just yet. But I will pick up the standard soul arrow. And we'll attune that over our heal miracle. We might want some of these rings later. I already picked up the catalyst from that body. But we'll save the souls for some leveling. So let's put our intelligence up, our faith up as well. And let's start moving towards some more attunement too. And we will attune our soul arrows. So what this loadout is going to look like eventually is this catalyst here. We're going to have a dagger, bandit's knife here for some limited melee combat. But this is how we're going through most of it with what you see here. You know, force people away, fire a soul arrow at them. So I think it'll actually work out pretty well. But that's it for now. That's going to be it for today's episode. So next time around, we'll head down, do a little farming with the bandit's knife. And I'll make it an extra long one so you can kind of skip that part if you want and still get a good video. And after that, we'll fight Capra and open up the depths and maybe delve into there a little bit. But that's it for now. Thanks for watching. I'd remind you to like the video if you like it. Subscriptions are always great. And, you know, because that way you can get more videos and it works out for both of us. So, alright, thanks for watching, guys. Have a good one.